much better off. And we have things that are going on, like the recent tragedy in Charleston. That's just uncalled for.
Do you think that that's just mad men will be mad men? Or do you think that that's something else?
I think that a society is only as good as its worst people.
And we are evil people indeed, are we not?
I've had many debates with myself about government politics and how best to move things forward. And we've argued all types of states, socialist, revolutionary, communist, democracies, what have you. And it's my position that it does not matter what form of government you have, if you have bad people running. You'll have the best form of government there is. The American government, the Constitution, is a wonderful document. But if you have poor people enforcing it and executing the laws, they will find a way to turn it upside down. So this is why I say it is the hearts and the minds of the people in society. That is truly where progress is made.
Knowing what you know about South Carolina's history, her stubbornness, are you pleased with her recent decision to take down the flag of the Confederate flag?
It is a move in the right direction, because what it does is it acknowledges, even if it's just for political reasons, it acknowledges what the flag means to millions of national citizens. And that is a move in the right direction. Even if this horrible tragedy had to be the thing to bring that acknowledgement about the meaning of that flag, what it means to so many millions of American citizens, to its own citizens, then it's a step in the right direction.
People of that congregation may write
testimony that
to
what
it means to be
children
of God. Yes. To do what they did good, and
it's so nice to meet you, sir.
Same here,
and you are. I'm Pat Inchett from Midas, Pennsylvania. Yes. Some very strong battles
in Pittsburgh. Yes, it was.
So,
a friend of yours was not far away. You may remember me, John Brown, who lived in the Knox County for a while while he was with the
rebellion in Rochester. John, he came to visit me in Rochester when he was planning that.
Mm-hmm.
Stayed in my home for the summer before he was planning that.
Okay.
Did quite a bit of his planning there. This was one of the reasons why I had to flee the country. People thought I was a part of the plot.
Okay.
So I left the country, went to England.
Mm-hmm.
Poor daughter died shortly thereafter, causing me to return. But yes, John Brown's a good man, very good man. My friends were in here talking about the whites who assisted and aided in the Underground Railroad, and I tell people that John Brown is my favorite white man in America. That he is. He is my American hero.
There you go. You know, anybody can say what they want about him. Some say he's crazy, some say he's the saints. But he really stood there, regardless of what he was.
There's a very good book by a modern writer. I'm trying to remember his name. James McBride, I believe is his name. And he wrote a book about John Brown's reign. It's fictitious. Throw some barbs at me and my womanizer and drinking. But in any case, it's a historical fiction, you might enjoy. It's about Bird, the Good Lord Bird. Good Lord Bird by James McBride. I enjoy a good read. That's a very good one. He was in fact one year with the Maryland One Boy.
Strong.
The woman who housed him. at a, what do they call them? And back in your day, the boarding house, he and his assistants, and the
local, I believe today they call them hostels.
The little girls in the house, but they might be counterfeiters. Because in a matter of little girls, they peeked through the keyhole to see what they were doing. They had a lot of papers on the bed. But one of the things he said, he was Isaac Smith, because he couldn't exactly go around by John Brown. So he was Isaac Smith, and their mama was a widow. And when he would take his mining supplies out of town toward Virginia, the little girls were allowed to ride on top of the mining supplies.
Mm-hmm. Yes, you really like that book. It's awesome. It's told from the perspective of free black boy who went around as a girl and who went with Brown from Ohio all the way to Virginia. And it's a good historical.
Thank you so much for your time.
You're quite welcome. Thank you.